Everything will come to an end, and they will come to an end. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, then you will die the same way, and you will be resurrected the way you died. A police officer working in a Muslim country, he writes to a scholar and he says that my return to the Almighty Allah, his return to the Almighty Allah, he writes, one occasion we were on a highway and we were parked upon the hard shoulder, and all of a sudden everything's quiet. Me and my partner, we were talking. He says moments pass, and all of a sudden there was a big bang. The officer writes, and when we looked behind us, what did we see? A head-on collision. There was a head-on collision. He says we went running towards the car, and we found two young lads. We took these two young lads out and we put them on the side. We went running to help the other guy in the other car. But what did we find? That he was dead. And when we returned back to these two young lads, we asked the young lads, that who are you? Yet again, there was no reply. My partner started instructing them, that say, La ilaha illallah. Say, La ilaha illallah. But there was no reply. Yet again, my partner started instructing him, say, La ilaha illallah. Yet again, there was no reply. And when he repeated it again, he said, my partner instructed them to say, La ilaha illallah. Yet again, there was no reply. And at this moment, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, you will die the same way. And when he was on the verge of dying, instead of uttering kalima la ilaha illallah, he starts singing a satanic song. He says, shocked by this, my partner starts instructing him again, say la ilaha illallah. Yet again, the same thing. Both young lads were singing a satanic song. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, listening to music, then you'll die the same way, and you'll be resurrected the way you died. He says moments passed, waiting for the ambulance. The first one dies without the kalima la ilaha illallah. And the second one dies without the kalima la ilaha illallah. Knowing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever says la ilaha illallah at the time of his death, he will enter Jannah. Knowing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever says la ilaha illallah at the time of his death, then the fire of hell will be made haram upon this person. A second incident. A woman writes that, could you explain to me that did my husband die a good death, or did he die as a bad death? She writes that one occasion, me and my husband, we were sitting down on the sofa and watching a football match. We were watching a football match because my husband really loved football. And he was a supporter of Alan Shearer. And he used to love Alan Shearer. On his clothes, he used to have an autograph by Alan Shearer. In his bedroom, he used to have pictures of Alan Shearer. He used to have cards of Alan Shearer. She says, one evening, when my husband and I, we were sitting down, and my husband said that my back is hurting and my legs have become weak. She says, I phoned the ambulance. I phoned the ambulance, and after about 20 minutes, the ambulance arrives. They bring a stretcher in. And when they bore a stretcher in, they put this, my husband on the stretcher. And when they put my husband on the stretcher, my husband grabbed my hands. And when he grabbed my hands, he said to me, look after the children. I said to my husband, that you, 20 minutes you will be in the hospital and you will be back out. And what happens? They go towards the ambulance. And when they jumped in the ambulance, she says, my husband was looking at the house. It was like if he's not going to return. And the ambulance took us to the hospital. And when they took us to the hospital, and they checked my husband, and he found out that he was dying of cancer. And the cancer was so severe that he had reached his brain. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you lived. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, you will die the same way, and you will be resurrected the way you died. She says that they put the machines on my husband, and they said that your husband's only going to last for another few days, or maybe a couple of days, or maybe a few hours. So make the most of it. She says that I sat next to my husband, holding his hands, and I instructed him to say, La ilaha illallah. She says, my husband started looking out the window, and all of a sudden he started laughing. His laugh was so loud that the nurses came in, the doctors came in. And when the doctors came in, she says, my husband's body from the middle lifted. And he starts screaming, starts saying, I'm Alan Shearer, I'm Alan Shearer, I'm Alan Shearer. The machines turn off. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, then you will die the same way. May Allah save us. An Arab working in a Muslim country, a doctor, he says, working on a ward where there was many patients, and there was one patient that was suffering from kidney failure, and he had a couple of days to live. The doctor says that prior to few days before his death, his face turned blue, his eyes were bulging out, and he was making a gargling noise from his throat. It was like if someone was strangling him. The doctor says that moments passed, that the noise from his throat became so loud that the patients who were around him began to flee. The doctor says we had to seclude him. We had to seclude him in a separate room. And when we secluded him in a separate room, we phoned his father. And upon arrival of his father says, looking at the condition of his son, he says, oh doctor, is there any medicine that you give my child? The doctor says that he's dying of kidney failure, there is no cure. He says that give him some medicine that you could put his life to an end. Why? Because I cannot bear watching him going through this pain. Why? Because his face had turned blue, his eyes were bulging out, and he was making a gargling noise. It's like someone was strangling him from his throat. He says, moments passed. The father held his hand and instructed him, say, La ilaha illallah. Yet again, there was no reply. And he dies upon without reciting the kalima, La ilaha illallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that remember Allah, keep on remembering the terminator of pleasures, and that is death. Just as brothers today on the Alam Rock Road, they will say that, what is this kalima la ilaha illallah? This don't mean nothing to me. As one of the brothers on Alam Rock Road, there were some few brothers who were doing a da'wah stall on Alam Rock Road. And there was a young lad who was driving a car and he was blasting his music. And when he parked up, one of the brothers went to him and he said to him, my brother, please turn the music low. He says, who are you to tell me to turn the music low? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I work. Saturday, Sunday, I want to drive up and down and blast my music to right. The brother instructed him, come learn about Islam. He says, F Islam. This is these words. And he gets out the car. And the brother said to him, like, have some respect for the kalima. Look on the stall. Look on the front sheet. What does he say? He says the kalima. He goes, brother, this don't mean nothing to me. It's only a piece of paper. Let me tell you the value of this piece of paper. Never mind just being a piece of paper. This is the very thing that will take him to Jannah. The hadith recorded by Imam Tirmizi in his Sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that on the day of judgment, Allah will raise everyone from the beginning of time till the end of time. Every single person will be resurrected from Adam right till the day of judgment. Every single person will be resurrected. And the scenery on that day will be, my brothers, that you will see some people who will be sweating up to their ankles. Some will be sweating up to their knees. Some will be sweating up to their waist. Some will be sweating up to their chest. Some will be sweating up to their collarbones. And some will be drowned in their own sweat. On that day, you will see people that their bodies will be split into two halves. You'll see on that day, people will be walking on their faces. You'll see people on that day, they will be blind. You will see people on that day that their private parts will be on their face and blood and pus will flow from it. You will see on that day, the one who takes his intoxicants will be wrapped, the intoxicants will be wrapped around his neck. You will see some people that will be made small as ants. You'll see other people who will have no arms. You have other people, the snakes will be wrapped around their neck. You'll have other people, their tongues will be down towards their waist. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there will be a servant of Allah